Like I was saying earlier also in an interview upstairs that this is the best phase of my life. It feels like my life has been fulfilled because I think I became a dad at the right time when I was ready for it, and I took that step only when I was sure of myself and what I was getting into. And he has really completed my life. He's a total joy to be around, and I'm enjoying every milestone of his. Because it feels like as if I'm reliving my own childhood all over again. And it doesn't feel like it's too much responsibility because I'm enjoying myself. Of course, it's a lot of work. It's very time consuming, but I wouldn't call it hard work because I'm really enjoying this, every minute that I spend with him. And I don't like to miss even a moment, whether it's whether he's at home or at the park, or whether he's at these play areas. Of course, I opted for single parenthood. So that created a huge media boom almost, because it was one of the first few of its kind. So that kind of has brought in a lot of spotlight to him, but it's okay. I think it's fine because I'm giving him a normal upbringing, and he is going to learn and he's going to know as he grows up that this is not who he is. You know, just because he's getting photographed and he's a little bit in the limelight already, that's not who he is. He has to make his life and he has to become someone on his own. So that upbringing I will instill in him. Nevertheless, the paparazzi are part of my fraternity. They are friends. So it's a normal thing. I have to face it. So he knows, he's going to know that he'll have to face that too. And he's not going to be too struck or too... you know, it's not going to be like a shock to him when he grows up. The more used to he gets to it from now on only, it'll be more and more normal for him as in when he grows up into teenagehood and adulthood. So I don't think that's something that I should really worry about, as long as I give him the right upbringing.
That's really nice. So Tushar, you're looking very fit on the cover. So when did the fitness work first bite you?
I always... As I grew up, Dad always instilled in me this idea of always being fit, though I was not a very fit child. I was a very plump child. And then as I went into college and then went to the US to study further, I became more and more conscious about it. But it was only when I actually got into films that I really took it up seriously and worked out more regularly. But then again, I think the last 3-4 years when I've gotten into functional training is when I've really, really lost weight, and I can consider myself to be fit now, because that has really kind of changed my metabolism. It's given me a lean look, and even if I binge or if I cheat at times, you know, it doesn't really change my body structure, because now the metabolic rate and my structure itself has kind of gotten much more fit, so it doesn't really slack at any point. So thanks to functional training, and I have a very, very good nutritionist, you know, who guides me with my diet. So I don't starve myself. I eat a lot, but I eat the right things at the right time, and it keeps me happy and it keeps me satisfied rather than, you know, staying away from everything and just like, you know, binging one full day and getting everything back. That's not my mantra. My mantra is to live a healthy life and eat a lot of meals, but smaller meals and more often.
Thank you, Tushar.
My pleasure.
Now I open the floor to the media for questions.
Considering you as the first celebrity single dad, so just wanted to know about what are the challenges or difficulties you face for making this kind of business?
There weren't any challenges in the sense that when I went to Dr. Firuza Parikh and expressed my desire to be a single father through the process of surrogacy, IVF and surrogacy, we were within the law. So she said it is legal. It is, a lot of people have done it. A lot of single women have done it mostly. So it was within the law. So I didn't really have any challenges to face as far as that is concerned. But obviously my own inner nervousness was there because I was taking a step as a single dad that hadn't been done too often before, especially in the world of entertainment. So I was a little apprehensive that what will the reactions be? Will there be too many questions? Will there be too much brouhaha about it? So that anxiety was there, but I was clear in my mind that this is what I wanted to do. So I took up that challenge and I'm glad I took it up because I'm a happier person today.
Nisha, so you recently had a very big hit in Golmaal.
Ji.
Which is almost crossing 300 crores.
200 crores, it's close, yeah.
So, has it given any flip to your career? I mean, will we see more of you on the screen and page?
Definitely, it's, a hit film is always beneficial to every actor. And it has, gotten me even more recognition than before, especially with the audiences and the families who love watching films like Golmaal, and it's the highest, most viewed film on satellite ever, you know. So that also adds, you know, because there are now more people watching the film on satellite, on the digital medium also. More offers have come, more scripts come my way now, but I have to be more selective and not, you know, make a mistake that will probably erode into what Golmaal has given me, you know.
The character of the dumb boy, how did you prepare for that? Did you learn any sign language?
Yeah, I did a workshop in 2005 before I started the first part of the franchise of the series, and there was a theatre actor, his name is Vikas Kadam, and he was asked to come and train me. So we did a workshop for around 15-20 days wherein, you know, I kind of learned how, what this character would require to be doing, you know, in on screen, you know, to make him more interesting rather than just do sign language, you know, which was done by then. A lot of films had mute characters using sign language to convey, but we wanted to go different. We wanted to really have his body language be a certain way, his facial expressions, and then he could probably make sounds also because he can hear, because he's not somebody who's deaf and mute. He's just mute, so he can hear sounds. He knows what sounds are like, so he makes his own sounds. So all these three things put together, the sounds, the body language, the facial expression, should be such that people can understand what he's trying to say, but at the same time, you know, he's mute, so it's not clear. So that balance we had to create, wherein this character appears endearing, funny, and naughty at the same time. And Vikas helped me a lot. So after the workshop only, we went on the shooting floor, and he used to be there, and it was like there were two directors. One was Rohit and the other one was his assistant Vikas, who was kind of directing me at the same time. So it was hard, it was tough, but I think the second part was a little easier. The third part, they challenged me with an emotional scene. So Rohit wanted to change the whole graph of this character, and he gave me a very tough emotional scene. And then in the fourth part, there was a scene wherein he gets possessed and he has to start talking. So every Golmaal film, there's been something new with regards to this character that makes it more fresher and keeps it novel.
Recently there has been a controversy about Saroj Khan, who commented on the going on in the industry. So what are your views on
that? It's a very tough question because you know, everybody has a different perception when they see someone talking. So a lot of people, you know, took it in a negative light, but honestly my opinion is that I don't think she meant it the way it was perceived. She was just trying to be fair on the film industry, wherein, you know, she tried to say that, you know, you can't really single out the film industry as one wherein such incidents take place. And even if they do, they probably happen on the fringes of the industry with people who claim to be part of the film industry, but they're not really part of the film industry. So maybe she was just trying to say that. She was not trying to kind of, in my opinion, you know, everybody has their own opinion. In my opinion, I don't think she was trying to justify the casting couch. I thought she was just trying to say ki aap film industry ki baat mat karo, ye sab jagah hota hai. That is what I saw it to be.
What do you think
Lush
would be after Rosa? Actor, TV actor, like a film star?
I really have no clue. Right now he enjoys...
Some characteristics in him right now.
Yeah, he's quite an actor already. You know, chashme pehenke phir usse aa jata hai mirror ke saamne baar baar. And he's... When he cries also there's 50% drama crying. Like all children do that. The terrible twos have started. So the drama crying and the tantrums have started. But he's also loves books. He's quite academic, so he's quite balanced in that sense. So I don't really know what he would be interested in. At my job would be given the right education wherein he's not just restricted to study or just not restricted to one thing, wherein he gets exposed to lots of things so that he can decide really which area he'd like to focus on.
Most of the actors start very early in child artists.
No, I don't think so. Maybe in school, maybe, you know, on stage, but I don't think I'd want him to get into movies that soon, unless he surprises me and he says, you know, that he's interested in doing something. The kids today, they pick up so fast, you know, they're doing what we would do at 4 years, they're doing at 2 years, you know, because there's so much exposure and, you know, there's play school and pre-play school and nursery and everything starts early, so you never know.
Have you seen any movies of yours?
No, he's not allowed to watch TV or movies for, like, you know, movies abhi nahi hai. He just watches nursery rhymes while he's eating. He's allowed to watch, but not more than one hour a day. Movies abhi samajh bhi nahi aayega, and theater mein le jaunga to I don't think 2.5 ghante tak baithega bhi wo. Very restless.
Tushar, who is your fitness icon? Any model or star that you follow in Hollywood or in Hindi?
I think our Hindi film heroes are the fittest. I think they're fitter than the Hollywood stars also. I mean, look at the Khans, look at Akshay, even Ajay. I mean, they are all in their late 40s, early 50s, and they look like they are fighting fit, competitive to the core. You know, even the senior actors of my dad's generation, you know, I think when they were nearing 50, they were kind of, you know, slowing down and not so fit in that sense. But I think the people, the actors today who are on top, they are... worthy of being icons for sure.
Hi, Tushar. Yeah. So, why is it that we see you doing more comedies than any other genre?
I think people presume that I like to do more comedies or that I'm better at that. But I have done other films like Khaki, Shoot in the City, Mujhe Kuch Kehna Hai, the Shootout series. Dirty Picture, which haven't been comedies, and they have worked, but somehow I think because the Golmaal franchise is so successful and has become synonymous with me and that character, that I think somewhere, I mean, I'm stuck in a box that everyone thinks of me only in that space. You know, when producers and directors probably approach me, they only come to me with comedy scripts. But every now and then I try to break that, you know, stereotype, and I hope to do that once more again.
Vishal, how is your equation with your sister? And why don't we see much of you in the TV shows or films of Balaji
production? She does, whenever she needs me in a role or the director requires me to play a character, of course I do work with her. The last time we did was Kya Kule Hum. So it's not that I don't work with her, we do work together. And it's a more professional kind of a relationship. Wherever the director feels that I could do justice to a certain role that they are making, I'm offered. And if I like the script, if I feel that it's going to help my career, then I would do the film. So we don't really come into each other's space wherein, you know, she has to come to me with every film that she's making, if it's a good big film. And I have to say yes to everything that she offers me. We keep that professional and personal relationship very, very healthy and very, very... We keep it different, you know. We don't like to mix the two. Then, you know, things get a little... Then it becomes awkward also. She has to go with her career and I have to go with my career. I am going to be doing something with her. There is a project for Alt that the director, the showrunner of that project, he approached me, and it's going to be streaming on Alt, but we haven't started shooting yet. So once it's confirmed and, you know, once everything is locked, we'll probably make an announcement. But yeah, I will be doing something for Alt soon. No, it's not mine. I just did an episode. It's a web series that, it's like an interview based web series. It's, I don't even remember the name of the lady who, she interviewed me, but it's based on it's a kind of parenting kind of web series. And I just came as a guest in one episode. So it's not that I'm there in that web show.
How have your parents and sister taken to your son?
They are obsessed with him. So he's like their son too, and my parents feel like it's a new lease of life for them, because they had to really wait to see a grandchild. And I feel secure that if I'm not at home, they're there. And we have a camera in his room, so we can see, you know, online what he's doing and whether he's sleeping or not. So my parents actually wake up all night to see. They're constantly monitoring what he's doing. So I think Laksh has brought in the family even more together. Earlier on, we used to do our own thing, but now we have this common factor that can that brings us all together.
Any advice on parenting that you received from your parents that you would like to pass on to your son?
Any advice
on parenting that you received from your parents that you would like to pass it on? Anything?
Not really. You know, I read a lot, so I go to these baby center sites every now and then, and I catch up a lot on what I should be doing this week as he's turned this old. So I don't really take their advice in that sense. They don't really feel the need to advise me also, because I'm pretty much on the ball with everything that needs to be done at every stage. But they are, of course, a great help to me. And parenting styles are so different now. You know, the times are so different in the 70s and 80s when I grew up. And of course, there are lots of things that probably they did at that point of time that I have learned from, and there are lots of things that they kind of missed out on that I don't want to miss out on with my kids. So I think I do refer to my childhood experiences to learn from them and use them in my own parenting styles. But a lot has changed, so I have to really be independent and do what I think is right at this point. Oh, wow. I think when he's an adult, 18 is the age, right? 18. So only when he's 18. Till then, he can watch his grandfather's films. They were all very clean.
Okay. Any last questions?
Yeah.
So, what are when
is Bola Run going to release?
I don't know if it's going to release at all.
Okay.
And if it does now, then I'll have to run Bola Run. It's too old. It's kind of stale now, I think. You never know, actually. Purane zamane mein pichare 8-10 saal bhi delay hoti thi, chal jati thi. Like Bond 303 was a film that released much late, and even there used to be lots of films that got delayed and then still did well. But today, I think everything changes so fast that things get outdated really fast. So I don't know. I think Neeraj ji also is not there anymore. Sadly, the director of the film is no more, and I would have loved to have that film released at the right time, but this is something that it's a mystery now.
Okay, Tushar, thank you so much for coming. Media, I'd like to thank you all for being here. We've had a fabulous evening. I hope everyone has a good day.
Thank you.
I chose this as the best one for the time. I think.